What's up guys, it's Zeph from Techsaurus, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at some gaming gear from Cougar. We've got the Revenger, a premium gaming mouse, the Bunker, a mouse bungee which is actually the first I've used with a suction cup, and finally the Immersa, a pair of budget headphones. So let's kick things off with the Revenger, and yes, it looks just as badass as it sounds. It's light at about 111 grams, and here's a quick tour of the mouse. It has an ergonomic design for comfortable stretches of use. There's two buttons on the left side, DPI indicators at the front, lights on the back, textured rubber for a solid grip, and a cable coming off of the left side. In total, there are four buttons, two on the side, the DPI control, as well as the scroll wheel button. The mouse does have a slight hump near the back, which is comfortable for palm grippers, but this mouse design accommodates for claw and finger type grip players as well. Let's move on to the 3360 optical sensor. So we have a 12,000 DPI, 1000 Hz polling rate, and a maximum tracking speed of 250 IPS. So what this all translates to is an accurate gaming experience. The tracking is smooth and there is no noticeable jitter when panning in game. The on-the-fly DPI control was also a nice touch. It allowed me to switch the speed in the game depending on character selection. So for example, if I was using a character that required more precision, such as a sniper, I would tone the DPI down for a more accurate aim, and vice versa. Moving on to the buttons, here's a listen on the click sound. Left and right, we have Armron switches, and they provide good audible feedback, and they're also tight. The other buttons are also tight, so there's no accidental clicks here. There's no extra sound when tapping it, and no rattle when shaking the mouse around either, and overall it just feels very well made. On the base, there are three large mouse feet which glide really smoothly across any mouse pad. In the Cougar software, you get a few controls. You can change the performance from 100 to 12,000 DPI. You can reroute the buttons with basic commands, record macros, and of course change the RGB color. A slight detail I noticed here was the gradient it would go through before switching colors. This is the first time I've seen this, and it's pretty badass. Overall, it's a solid gaming mouse, especially at $60. So I used the Revenger with the Bunker from Cougar as well, and before all of this, I used to think that mouse bungees were an overhyped gaming accessory. But with my time spent with this, it's actually pretty useful. It's nice not having to worry about the cables being kinked or caught while gaming. So what makes the Bunker special is the suction cup, and unlike other ones, this won't move around your desk at all. Looking around the Bunker, we see this lever here which controls the suction cup. The top is flexible and the bottom is solid plastic. It's about 10 centimeters tall and 6 centimeters wide with no height adjustment, but almost all mouse cables will be compatible with this. In conclusion, it's really nice using the mouse bungee, and it might have a place on my main desk. I can be moving my mouse around a lot and there will be no issues with cables getting snagged, which is really important when it comes to FPS games. It's around $20 on Amazon, so a bit steep for a mouse bungee, but it is a long-term investment nevertheless. And finally, the last product we have from Cougar is the Immersa, their budget headset solution. So right off the bat, I'ma say that these aren't going to compete with higher priced headsets in terms of audio quality, but with a 40mm driver and a noise cancelling microphone, the $54 package you get overall is impressive. The retractable microphone is flexible and it's 11 centimeters in length and holds its shape really well. Here's a quick unedited audio sample.
Rest of the microphone on the Cougar Immersa. The audio is untouched and recorded through Audacity. I've also tried recording through my phone and the sound quality carries over. As you can hear, there is very little background noise pickup from the microphone.
As you can hear, it's pretty good with very low background noise pickup, and this is all achieved without a driver filtering the noise. So this quality carries over to when you plug it into your smartphone, for example. The sound quality of the headset lacks punch in the bass, the mids are a bit mushy, and the highs aren't there quite either. But when I stopped analyzing the sound and just enjoyed the experience of gaming and listening to music, I didn't notice its shortcoming. After all, I'm no audiophile. It's one size fits all with its leather-like headband that adjusts when you put it on. I used the Immersus for long stretches of editing and gaming, and there wasn't any discomfort at all. The ear cups are well padded for comfort. The cable is braided and about 2 meters long, with a main volume control and mute toggle. Here's a quick audio test on the amount of sound bleed, one with the headsets on my head and one with them off. So in conclusion, these are all solid gaming peripherals for the price. If you guys are looking to pick up your next mouse or headset or even mouse bungee, check these guys out. I'll drop a link to them down below. But that's pretty much it for the video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.